हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द चैनल ट्यूटर बॉक्स। इन टुडेज क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एस्टैब्लिशिंग अ नेशनल प्रोग्राम ऑफ फार्माकोविजिलेंस। क्लियर? सो दिस इज अनदर सेक्शन इन द कैटेगरी ऑफ फार्माकोविजिलेंस लेक्चर सीरीज एंड दिस इज फ्रॉम द यूनिट 2। क्लियर? सो इन अर्लियर क्लासेस वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरियस यूनिट 1 एंड यूनिट 2 लेक्चर एंड इन टुडेज क्लास आई एम डिस्कसिंग दिस टॉपिक। So before moving forward, I am just requesting you all that those who have not subscribed the channel, please subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon as well. And as well as the notes of these section are available on our website, and the link of the notes I am giving you in the description box. So click on the link as well. So the first question in our mind that how to establish a national program for pharmacovigilance. So initially when there was a no program of pharmacovigilance, so we already discussed the history of the pharmacovigilance, how it was generated and how it was developing in the India. So the some of the portion we are covering again in this section, and we are describing that how this national program was established in India and what are its stakeholders and how it is useful to get the adverse event data and safety efficacy data of the medicine which are already in use and which are newly launched. Clear? So what happened in India? Initially in India ADR monitoring system started in India in 1986. So the first thing is that in 1986 India started the ADR monitoring. ADR means adverse drug reaction and monitoring, started in 1986 with 12 regional centers. So initially in 86 we have a 12 regional center, and these regional centers are doing the work of ADR collection. Then further, what happened in 1997, India become the member of WHO program for IDM managed by UMC. So what is the meaning of IDM? International Drug Monitoring. Okay, it means India has further taken more steps towards the pharmacovigilance. Clear? Then the people at that time, what happened, the doctors and even the healthcare professional are not much aware, but they are aware about the tragedies which had in the previous years, like thalidomide tragedy and various tragedies. That's why some of the physicians were interested to get the data related to the adverse event. So the Indian scientists and scientist community basically managed to become the member of WHO, and then further they become the member of IDM managed program. And after that, what happened? Initially we have a 6 regional center, and these 6 regional center were established at New Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Lucknow, Chandigarh and Puducherry. These were the basically a government hospital in which the ADR monitoring program was started. And in among them, only New Delhi and Mumbai were the two hospital from where we are getting the data. Rest of the centers were not much able to get the data. So initially physician and the healthcare professional are not much interested, and they were too much loaded by their work. So this was not happened as the scientist community thought. Then further, what happened in 2004? India launched a National Pharmacovigilance Program of India with the help of World Bank. And how much amount given by the World Bank is $0.1 million. Okay, and this program is for 5 years. So this program was ended into 2009. Then there was some progress from 2004 to 2009. Then further this program get it paced, and in 2010 Health Ministry launch a program of Pharmacovigilance Program of India. It aims New Delhi, and AIIMS New Delhi was the national coordination center. But further in 2011 it was shifted to the Indian Pharmacopoeial Commission, and further Indian Pharmacopoeial Commission were become as a national coordination center, and the Drug Controller General of India Dr. G.N. Singh were the heading at that time. Clear? Then after 2010 what happened? The PVPI was started, and under PVPI ADR monitoring started at एडवर्स ड्रग मॉनिटरिंग सेंटर्स. ओके, सो एडवर्स ड्रग मॉनिटरिंग सेंटर वर बेसिकली दीज आर द हॉस्पिटल अक्रॉस द इंडिया. सो AMC एस्टेब्लिश एट वेरियस रीजन्स ऑफ द इंडिया लाइक नॉर्थ रीजन, ईस्ट रीजन, साउथ रीजन और वेस्ट रीजन. सो दीज ऑल मेडिकल कॉलेजेस वर द गवर्नमेंट मेडिकल कॉलेज एंड दे आर MCI अप्रूव. सो इन PVPI वॉट हैपन, PVPI इनिशियली मेक द AMC इन एवरी स्टेट बेसिकली एंड दे मेक द जोनल सेंटर. ओके, एंड दीज जोनल सेंटर वर्क टू कलेक्ट द डाटा फ्रॉम देयर रीजनल सेंटर. रीजनल सेंटर फर्दर कलेक्ट द डाटा फ्रॉम देयर एवरी सिटी और वी कैन से एवरी मेडिकल कॉलेज विच आर लोकेटेड इन वेरियस एरिया ऑफ देयर स्टेट. सपोज इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द राजस्थान, देन इन राजस्थान इनिशियली देयर वाज 6 to 7 मेडिकल कॉलेजेस एट दैट टाइम. सो गवर्नमेंट मेडिकल कॉलेज वॉज अपॉइंटेड एज अ AMC, एडवर्स ड्रग मॉनिटरिंग सेंटर. And whatever the adverse drug reported by those AMC, they reported to the SMS Medical College. That was the regional center of Rajasthan. Clear? Now what happened? So these AMC become responsible to collect the ADR. Clear? So I already told you the how they are collecting the data. So AMC become responsible to collect the ADR as per the standard operating procedures and taking the follow-up. Clear? So whenever these regional or various city-wise medical colleges, okay, those city medical colleges are collecting the data, the people within those AMC particularly, they are trained to how to collect the data, clear, and how to report the data. Okay, so whatever the data collect by them, they fill those data in the VigiFlow. Now VigiFlow is a software used to upload the information of ADR monitoring, and it VigiFlow work for worldwide, clear. So from this VigiFlow, people from other countries also can take the information. So this is how the Indian people are trained, and then they further fill the data of ADR monitoring. Then individual case safety report is an important, ICSR is an important part of ADR monitoring, and this ICSR are collected in pre-designed ADR report form. And these ICSR has a 4 section. These 4 section are particularly, first section containing patient information, then the second section containing suspected adverse reaction, and the third section containing suspected medicine, and the fourth section containing reporter information. So all the things are covered by the ICSR, and whenever the ICSR is completely filled, then this ICR information will be moved to the regional center, and this regional center move this information to the zonal center, and then these zonal center move this information to NCC. NCC means Indian Pharmacopeial Commission, particularly for the India. And thus, then IPC India will move this information towards the UMC, Uppsala Monitoring Center, Sweden. And this information is moved through the softwares like VigiFlow, and there are various further many software developed by the UMC or healthcare professionals and professional bodies. Then further what happened? These ICSR reports to the NCC for quality and signal review, and how the healthcare professional get the information that the quality and signal are reviewed. So basically WHO, UMC, even a casualty assessment system. Okay, I already given a one lecture on casualty assessment of ADR. You can go through with that lecture and you can able to identify that various method of casualty assessment of ADR. So according to these casualty assessment criteria, the healthcare professional of pharmacovigilance able to get the quality and signal review, means they are able to identify the signals which are the basically a first sign of adverse drug reaction which is not able to identify in the clinical trials. So these quality and signal reviews are reviewed by the professionals, and these are reported to the VigiFlow. Clear everyone? Now between, if you are talking about the data, how much data is collected by the India, then from 2006 to 2008, In ICSR, almost 11,633 ICSR reports were there, and further it will grow from 2009 to 2014 to the 78,672 ICSR reports. So reports are increasing and healthcare professionals were updated their knowledge and they encouraged to report the information. So day by day there is an increase in the reporting system, but still there is some problems are also there. So besides ADR reporting, PBPI also developed medicine side effect reporting from form in the regional languages of India. That's why this is another reason why reporting is increased, because if the ADR reporting form is in the regional language, then the layman can also fill these forms as well. Okay, sometimes health professionals also are not very frequent with the English language, so regional languages are very important, and this is the reason behind the increase in the reporting as well. Still, if we are talking that the reports are increased, but if you are talking about the population of the India have and how much medicine they are consuming, so consumption and population, if we are talking about the consumption of the drug and the population, and then we are comparing both of these things with the ICSR reports, then the ICSR reports are very, very less. Okay, they are less than 0.1%. Clear? So it means what happened? Reporting is less. Now we must know why reporting is less, still less. So there are some reason, just because of those reason the reporting is less. So the scientist community who are related with the pharmacovigilance work, they identify those reason and they try to encourage the ICSR reporting. So why encourage? And they identify that there are some area where they need to encourage the people associated with them. So now we must understand who are those people who are associated with these whole system. So the first one is physician, second we can say pharmacist, nursing and paramedical staff, then third one is the patient, and the fourth one is pharmaceutical company. These are the four person who, for them we can say these are considered as a stakeholder of pharmacovigilance. So all of these, if encouraged and educated, then there is a possibility of increase in the reporting. As we know, the patient is one of the biggest stakeholder. Clear? So if patient is educated about the ADR and ADR reporting, then there is an increase in the ADR reporting. So in country like India or Asian country, or we can say developing country, where patient is less educated about the reporting of the ADR, that's why this is the major concern. Okay, how we can encourage the physician? So basically we must increase the communication between all these P's. P means physician, again P means pharmacist, or then nursing staff or paramedical staff, and then patient, and then pharmaceutical company. So communication between them, particularly communication between physician, pharmacist, nursing staff or paramedical staff and pharmaceutical company, that is important. Okay, so if they have the communication, because nursing staff, so many times nursing staff is more close to the patient, and pharmacist also giving the drugs, and they are, the patients somewhat feel easy with the paramedical staff. So there is a possibility that patient may tell their responses of the drug to these paramedical staffs, or we can say physicians as well. So if there is a communication, then there is a possibility of increase in the ICSR. Then financial incentive for medical and non-medical staff. If there is a concept of financial incentives, then there is also a possibility to increase the reporting system. Then lack of time and overload. Generally what happened in India, number of physicians is very less, or paramedical staff is very less in comparison to the patient. So ratio is too much less, means patient are high and doctors are less. That's why for each and every patient, doctor visiting time is also less. So they are not having too much time to discuss these kind of things like pharmacovigilance, as well as they are overloaded. Then ignorance is another thing that is also one more important one, and apprehension of reporting the serious EDR. So this can be considered as well. Then required training program, CME or advertisement. This is also another important point which can help in the establishing the national pharmacovigilance program. So regularly we are seeing that they are regularly continuing medical education program as well as advertisement, and PVPI also launched the app to report the EDRs. Clear? Then just look, appointment of PV officer at the every government or private hospital. So generally at currently most of the EDR reporting is from the government's EDR reporting from the private sector is very less. Still there is no rule to appoint the pharmacovigilance officer in the particularly we can say in government and private hospital. If there will be a rule, then this may increase the EDR reporting. And India contribution in the Vigibase database was 2% till 2013. So still we can say till 2013, if you are taking about the whole of the world, then India contribution in the Vigibase database is only 2%. So from this data you can also see that how much less reporting we are doing. Clear? So this is how the Indian national program was established. Now just look on the flow of the information within the national pharmacovigilance program. So basically CDSCO, this is the major organization in India, Central Drug Standard Control Organization. Okay, and this Central Drug Standard Control Organization, it has a various stakeholders. Okay, so stakeholders like pharmaceutical company, patient, physicians, okay, paramedical staffs, all we can say stakeholders. Then CDSCO made some zonal centers. So information CDSCO has made some zonal center, and these zonal centers as well as sub zonal center. So north zonal center, south zonal center, east, west zones centers, and all these center will report information to the, they identify the information like signal review, core training panels, as well as quality review panels. They are doing these kind of things, and then these reports are informed to the NCC IPC Ghaziabad, as well as there are also strategic advisory committee. Whatever the reports get by them, these strategic advisory committee and steering committee further take the decision, and then this decision will be forwarded to the NCC IPC Ghaziabad. As well as we also have a national healthcare program, pharmaceutical company and professional body. All these also gave their information and their advices to the IPC Ghaziabad, and all the information which is collected by NCC IPC Ghaziabad will moved to the UMC Sweden, Uppsala Monitoring Center Sweden. So this is how we are getting the information. And particularly if we are talking about the CDSCO zonal sub zonal center, then each CDSCO zonal center has a AMC, Adverse Drug Monitoring Center. So if you are talking about the Rajasthan, then SMS Medical College is the center. If you are talking about the Chandigarh, then PGI Chandigarh is the center. And if you are talking about the Delhi, then AIIMS is the center. As well as if you are talking about the Guwahati, then Guwahati Medical College is the AMC. Okay, so they also report, each and every center will report to their region center, and region center report to the zonal center, and zonal center report to the NCC IPC. Clear everyone? So this is how the information is flow. So this is all about on establishing national pharmacovigilance program, and I hope you people are able to understand whole of the flow of the information, how the collection of the data, how pharmacovigilance program was established in India, and how it is increase its span day by day. And you are looking that there is a strengthening of the pharmacovigilance program of India, and day by day we are increasing the ICSR reporting. So here I discuss the some questions with you guys, as well as notes of this section is also given in the description box. So check the description box of the video, and if you think this lecture is useful, then hit the like button and share this video to your friends as well. Jai Bharat, Jai Hind.